Hey guys, welcome to the channel. At the end of World War II, piston-powered aircrafts were reaching the limit of development. However, the need for much faster aircrafts were still present. As we discussed in our previous video, conventional piston-powered aircrafts were able to go as fast as 700 kilometers per hour and not more than that. A major factor preventing aircraft from going any faster was drag. But this could be avoided by climbing up to higher altitudes where the air is much thinner. Since most aircraft of that time used an internal combustion engine, at higher altitudes, these engines were not able to get sufficient air for complete combustion. This led to a huge drop in their performance. So, a newer type of engine was developed. It was called the jet engine. The development of the jet engine was started before the World War broke, but it was not proceeded further as there was no metal strong enough to withstand the intense heat that is produced in the combustion chamber. But as the war progressed, the need for this new type of engine was recognized and it received more funding. A new metal alloy made up of nickel chrome steel and molybdenum was created to withstand the extreme conditions of a jet engine. In a jet engine, air is sucked into the engine and compressed by a series of compressors. It is then mixed with vaporized fuel. This air-fuel mixture is then ignited by an igniter, which is similar to the spark plug used in automobiles. This causes rapid combustion and expansion of fuel-air mixture, which is trapped and used to rotate a series of turbine blades before exiting the engine through a nozzle, and in this process, it generates a whole lot of thrust. This thrust is what propels the plane forward. Modern jet engines use a multi-stage axial compressor to compress the air. However, most early jet engines used a radial compressor to compress the air. A radial compressor uses centrifugal force to compress the air and forces it into the combustion chamber. Radial compressor engines are normally used in helicopters as they have the advantage of being short in length for the amount of power they produce. However, centrifugal compressors quickly reach diminishing returns because you can only have a maximum of two compressor wheels back to back before going with a larger diameter compressor. Subsequently, this limits the speed at which you can spin the compressor. Axial compressors are arranged lengthwise because you need several stages of compression in sequence to achieve a rate of compression similar to that achieved in a single stage radial compressor. The first jet engine aircraft to fly ever was the Heinkel HE-178. It used a jet engine with a radial compressor for compression. This aircraft was capable of flying at speeds of 700 kilometers per hour and produced 1100 pounds of thrust. But it burned fuel at such a high rate that it was able to remain airborne only for a few minutes. Similarly, the Junkers Jumbo 004 was the world's first axial compression engine. This engine was capable of delivering 1900 pounds of thrust and had an 8-stage axial compressor. All right, that's it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions or comments, please drop them in the section below. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.